The parent offspring connection in the afterlife. In India, when people die, they want to have their children around them. People particularly want sons to be around. This is the reason why in India, people desperately want to have a son. This is because there is a certain life connection between the children and the parents. And if you make use of it in doing rituals for parents, they can be much more effective. Daughters too are effective for this purpose, but people dependent more on the sons for this role, mostly because in the past it was only possible for the son to be around when they were dying. When the daughter came of age, she got married and went to someone else's house. When the parent died, she may not have been able to come immediately because of the distance. She need not be in another continent, even if she were just 200 kilometers away. By the time she came, the cremation would have been over. Moreover, she would have her own children, husband and family. She could not just drop them and come away. She would have to make arrangements for her absence. And she could not travel alone because everything would be forested, so someone would have to escort her. Making all these arrangements would take considerable time and she would not be able to reach in time. But the son lived with the parents, so he would be available. So they said the son must be present for the rituals, and it is sufficient for the daughters to come by the 12th day. So what is the nature of this connection between the parent and the child that could be made use of at that time? Generally, people's interaction with each other is physical, mental, or emotional. It never goes beyond that. But when a person dies, or when a person sheds his or her body, all that is gone. The mental structure is gone, the emotions are gone, the body is for sure gone. So everything that you knew as yours is gone. So for all practical purposes, the children are as much a stranger to you as anyone. But once you bear a child, a certain space of who you are is occupied by that being, whom you refer to as your child. Because you provided a body for this being. It is because of this connection that the parent has with the child that we can do certain things which can help parents after they die. If the child does the right thing after the death of the parent, he can even liberate the parent through this connection. People who lived completely unaware and did not do anything about themselves depended on their children to liberate them, and that became a whole tradition by itself. However, the reverse is not true. You cannot use the parents to liberate their dead offspring. We already saw in the previous section that when children die before they are four, the death is not the same as an adult's, because that life is still establishing itself. After the child crosses somewhere between 40 to 48 months, physiologically your connection with the child increases dramatically, and it happens in your body. Most people don't decipher this. They experience something happening within them before 4 years of age. But after 4 years, they are involved with so many child-related issues. Where he is going, where he is, his school admission, this and that. Because of these things, they miss this experience. Otherwise, at that time, they would notice that something clicks in them because something in that body has clicked in. When that clicks in, you come to a certain ease, because it becomes a part of you. You don't have to consciously hold it. A natural holding happens. You must understand that You are only a provider of the body for your child. You cannot create a being. It is not in human hands to create a being. When that being really clicks onto the body that you provided, something clicks on within you and occupies a certain space within your own system. This is how, if we just check someone's energy, we know whether they have had a children or not. This is how sometimes an astrologer in India is able to tell you how many children you have, whether they are surviving or not. They will give you a brief synopsis of your children, their characteristics, their names, and everything. Because your children occupy a certain space within you, if you are willing to observe, it is very much there in that person. Now, this physiological connection is very strong until the child is 21 years old. After that, it starts dissipating once again. It is because of this, as a child grows up and becomes close to 21, if you look at them, they look like absolute strangers. You cannot believe you bore them. You will wonder, are these my children? Is this the same little baby that I brought up? You cannot recognize what they are doing because you don't have an abode in them, but they have an abode in you. This is a beautiful natural system of caring for the offspring, bringing it up, and also being capable of releasing it when you have to. If someone comes up to me and says, "Bless my children," I ask, "How old are they?" If they are below 21 years, we really bless them, because if they are below that age, you can bless a mother or a father and have a deep impact on the children. But if the children are over 21 years of age, we just banter with their parents, joke with them, and send them away, because it is no use blessing them for their children. The children will have to come themselves. This is why, if your parents die, we can do something for them through you. But if your children die, we cannot use you to do something more for them, because they don't have that little space within them that is occupied by you. It is always so that the future generation occupies a little space in the past, but the past generation will not and cannot occupy any space in the future generation. This is the very nature of things. So once your children are gone, all you can do is perform Kala Bhairava Karma for the child within the stipulated time. It will definitely do something significant. Beyond that, don't try to do too many things to influence them. However, though your thoughts, your emotions, and your actions have no influence over your child who is no more, if you turn inward, if your way of being becomes pleasant, that being will experience pleasantness. This also is only until that life finds another body. If I say these things, people will get confused, but if you are a little observant, you can sense when this departed being has found another body. You may have seen this happening with many people who have lost children. Until a certain point, they cannot believe that they will ever recover from the death of their children. But suddenly, one day, it does not seem to matter anymore. Everything seems to be normal and fine. If the parents observe the way their body behaves, how the breath behaves, the nature of their hair, their fingernails, the texture of their skin, they will know when this being has found another body. It will show. A close observation of the breath will reveal that the pattern of breath has moved from being tense and short to a distinct level of ease. This will also reflect in various other ways. The natural hydration process of the skin will change from dryness to softness due to the respiratory action of the epithelial. There are many more indicators I will not go into them because people will start looking and start imagining all kinds of things. Now, once that life finds another body, then it is done for good. You have nothing to do with it. Now someone else claims them. This is my child. And a whole new drama begins again.